welcome everyone to our kickoff meeting of Give Local, 2017. Thanks for coming out on this Friday morning. And as we like to do, we'll start off with some introductions. First, I'd like to introduce the new team. Well, I'm not new. I've been around. Meredith Friends, Executive Director of Missoula Community Foundation. But new to our Missoula Community Foundation team is Nikki Robb, who is, many of you know. She has joined us as a program associate and will be your liaison, taking the lead with our Give Local campaign. So, welcome to Nikki.
Hello, everybody. We'll just kind of do some intros, so I'll start. I'm Nikki. I'm from Missoula. I've been doing fundraising events for nonprofits here for the last 3-4 years, and I've been working on Give Local for the last couple years, and I'm really excited to be a part of Give Local this year. We've got some really exciting things coming up, so thank you guys for coming.
Okay, and so we did some nonprofit surveys many of you participated in, and donor surveys also many of you participated in, because I know that I'd say a lot of the nonprofit people also donate. So we got some really good data, and we wanted to just share some highlights of that. And so I'll be sharing the donor data, and Nikki will be sharing the nonprofit. 21% hadn't given online before Give Local. So that was some progress, I thought. 35% had heard about it from a friend, family member, or coworker. So, and that was data that came out, was people were talking about it. So that was kind of fun. 87% supported nonprofits that they already support or have supported in the past. 30% supported nonprofits they were aware of but had never supported before. And 6% supported nonprofits they learned about through Give Local. So, you know, most of it was people that are supporting the same nonprofits they already support. So I think that there's room for growth there in the way that we promote the day as a whole to, you know, more of the quote-unquote general public, so that they can discover nonprofits that they haven't supported before, maybe people who haven't given to nonprofits before. In evaluating the giving guide, the independence giving guide, I know that that took quite a bit of time for you as nonprofits to complete, as well as staff time and just trying to gauge, as well as time that the independent took to put it together, a lot of time and printing and all of that. So evaluating, is it really worth it? So we asked questions about that, and you know, 26% of respondents even saw the giving guide, and folks didn't necessarily seem to think it was super helpful. So, well, cat out of the bag, we're not gonna do the giving guide. That was something I was gonna say later, but anyway, you know, just, we want to make everything, make this all worth everybody's time. You know, your time is precious, and so we don't want you spending it on something that isn't that helpful. So we can do better, and we commit to doing better on that. Will you participate again, donors? 89.66% said yes, even though their experience wasn't necessarily great. They cared enough, but we want people who don't care that much to be able to give, even if they have an impulse to give, we want them to be able to. So, 10.8% were unsure, so we want to convince them, yes, this is going to be awesome. And only 0.26, or just one person, said they wouldn't participate again. So, some interesting data, and we did send out an email with a link to the full data that you can check out if you'd like.
Thanks, Meredith. All right, so I'm going to give you guys some of the highlights from the nonprofit survey, so from you guys. One of the things that I found most interesting was the question that we asked about how many staff members everybody has for development, for this fundraising. And asking that question, 45% of people said they have 0 staff members for that. So that was pretty shocking to me. So we clearly need to simplify the process and make this whole fundraising effort a little bit easier for you guys. So 45% said there was 0, and 39% said there was 1%, or 1 person. So we clearly need to simplify the process. boot camps. So this is kind of an informal boot camp, but we had several boot camps last year, social media, board engagement. We had some other boot camps. So after asking the nonprofits about attending the boot camps, 50% did not attend. So again, this capacity of having zero people to attend these functions is kind of a bummer. So we want to, again, make this information more accessible to people on their own time. We are still going to do boot camps, but we're going to make them more effective, less opportunities to have someone to choose from. We'll pick a couple. If you can make it, great. If not, we'll have that information available to you. But they're going to be good this year, so you should definitely come.
Doing webinars, too, that you don't necessarily have to attend, but that you can watch. Sorry.
Yes, which will be helpful, too. You know, it's hard for people to come to these kind of functions at 9 in the morning or in the afternoon on Friday or whenever it might be. So we're going to make it easier. Some of the comments that I got from the boot camps that you guys might find a little bit interesting. One of them said, yes, the boot camps were really good for our board members. I think that's an important bit of information. This is a great opportunity to bring your board members to these boot camps so they can get an understanding of how to make this event more successful and get them on board. Because we all know if the board's not on board, we have a problem. Another great comment was, yes, I went to the boot camps. They were especially helpful to share ideas with other nonprofits. So I just want to point that out again too, that it is a really good opportunity for people to say, what are you doing? What are you doing? How's your campaign going? Do you have any suggestions about this? And to get people to work together. Some of the more successful nonprofits last year did things by working together. Historical Museum partnered with the Humane Society. They had an amazing donor lunch, Puppies and Pizza, you can't beat it. So the boot camps are worth attending. So if you get an opportunity to attend one of them, you definitely should. So the share fund, most of the responses and the comments on the share fund said that it was highly important for the nonprofits to participate and give local because we have the share fund. So I just want people to know, over the last few years we've struggled on what's the best way to explain the share fund and what's the best way to get that money out there. We are brainstorming some really fun and exciting new ideas to make it more fair, give everybody a chance. And it's just going to be a lot better. So there's going to be a share fund. We're hoping it's going to be bigger this year, and it's going to be a lot more attainable. So just wanted you guys to know, we asked and we listened, and we're making some big changes this year. So now, those are our survey results, or some highlights from. Let's talk about some important dates. We are currently in the process of making the webpage, so we're doing that right now. So January is the time to start signing up. So take note of that. Giving this year will begin on April 1st. So this year, we are allowing people to give early. It will not show up on the website. It will not show up on the leaderboards. But people can get on as early as April 1st and start donating, which is fantastic because we all know one of the issues with this event is people think about it, they think about it, and the day comes and goes, and they forgot about it. So we're giving people an opportunity to donate a month in advance. So that's great for you guys. Another board date. Registration ends April 7th. So we've got a lot more time involved, but the earlier you get in, the more marketing you can do, the more information you can spread about your nonprofit. So get in as early as you can. It's just going to help you guys out in the long run. And then finally, the giving day. So, big changes, you guys, big changes. So this year's Giving Day. I know we've always gone with the first Tuesday in May, but we're no longer going with Kimia and the nationwide thing. Another survey result, turns out Montanans don't care about donating outside the state of Montana. We are Montana and we are proud. So, we have decided to do a sort of a statewide. Everybody's either doing May 4th or May 5th, or a combination of both, which is what we're gonna do. So this is a 24-hour online giving event, and we've been doing the midnight to midnight. That's hard. It's been hard. It's hard to kick off at midnight. It's hard to end at midnight. So we've decided to start at 6 p.m. on May 4th and go till 6 p.m. on May 5th. So that is a Thursday evening to a Friday evening. That's going to be great for us, you guys. We can really capitalize on those hours where people are sitting at their computers and they are, you know, doing things at home, or they can get on and donate. They can come to a donor lounge and have a party and celebrate. They can come Friday evening and celebrate and get the results with us. So I think this is going to be really good for all of us to have changed this May 4th and 5th. May the 4th be with you.
Yeah, so we're pretty excited about this, as you can tell.
So, yes, the name is changing. It's not going to be Give Local anymore. It's going to be Missoula Gives. Two words, simple, easy. Love it. So that's what it'll be going forward. The platform is changing from our friends who did admirably the first 2 years but didn't do so great this last year. So we're going with a new company called GiveGab, and we pretty much once May 5th rolled around, you know, after what happened, we were like, okay, we need to start looking at our options, and we did consider our current or the provider that, you know, we went with this year. But we had demos with, I think, four different providers. Nikki did a lot of work just figuring out, you know, all of the different features, looking at the security, you know, the architecture. So what happens when the site goes down? What's their backup, and what's their backup of their backup? And we had one of our board members, Leland Buck, he creates websites and designs websites, and he knew the right questions to ask, and he knew what the right answers were. And so I feel like we had a really good team in place to evaluate our best options, and I feel really good with the choice that we made of GiveGab out of Ithaca, New York. And they're just really excited to work with us. We're really excited to work with them. One of their big, as I said it in the email, they're obsessed with the donor experience, which I want us to be as well. You know, it needs to be fun, it needs to be easy and simple. They really want to work with us. You know, Charlie flew out and was here for the Montana Nonprofit Association Conference and actually sponsors some research that MNA does along with other state associations in the region. Anyway, so came out, met with us, and then once we decided to go with them, their whole team flew out and was with us, and we had a kickoff meeting. And so we just know, and they're already providing a superior service, so we're just very excited about that. And so those are some of the kind of overall changes, and Nikki's going to talk about more specific to nonprofits, and then I'll talk about more specific to donor.
So you may or may not be grasping the overall theme here, but we are really trying to simplify the process. Really trying to make this easy for everybody, which is part of the reason we chose GiveGab. First of all, they help out so much. They've got a little chat button at the bottom of your computer, so anytime you have a question, you're stuck, you can just chat right to them and they'll answer it for you. So you don't have to send an email to me or to Meredith or to the Community Foundation to get your question solved. They'll be right there to help you right away, which is great. So we're really trying to simplify. We're going to offer more training opportunities, like we mentioned. The company that we're working with has several webinars in play. For example, how to register and build your profile, storytelling and marketing best practices, peer-to-peer fundraising, review last-minute strategies, and how to keep your giving day momentum after the day. So there's a lot of really good information that's going to be available and put together by professionals that do this for a living that are going to be able to help you guys and your campaign be way more successful this year. So that's exciting stuff. The webinars we will make available. I think we'll probably have them at some boot camps, but we will try to make them available on the website so that you guys can watch those at your leisure as well. We are definitely not doing the giving guide, as we mentioned. One of the great things about GiveGab is your profile page is like your profile page. Instead of having a giving guide, on your page you get to put your story. You can have a video up there. You can decide what donation increments you want to encourage people to donate to you. You can have pictures. It's really your page. So we don't feel like we need to do the giving guide because this is an opportunity for you to shine on the website. Whereas in past years it's been, you've got your mission statement, what you do, what category you're in, a little bit of information, but not much. This is going to be way more pretty with bells and whistles that shine for your guys' organization. It's going to be great. Fewer lead-up events. Again, with the best overall campaign and the lack of capacity with our nonprofits, we realize it's hard to come to all these. So we're not going to have four pint nights and three of these events and two of these and five of those. So we're going to simplify it. So when we do send out dates to those things, if you can come, show support for your organization, but just don't worry that there's not going to be too many of those events this year. One of the greatest things about GiveGab as well is this is not just a one and done kind of event. By working with GiveGab, their platform is year-round. So after our events, let's say in the middle of the summer or in the fall, you guys decide to do a different kind of campaign. You can create your own campaign, use this website that your donors have already been going to, and use that. So that's great and exciting news. You can use this multiple times. They have other really great products, donor management systems and whatnot too, that you can inquire about if you enjoy the product. So we already kind of mentioned we're reconsidering how to do the incentive funds. We're trying to find the best, most fair way for everybody to be incentivized. So stay tuned for big ideas about that. And finally, in years past, we've always had a steering committee that does the Give Local and several other committees. We do still have some volunteer positions open. If anybody wants to get more involved and more hands-on and join any of those committees, please just see me or Meredith afterwards, or feel free to give me a call from the Community Foundation. All right, Meredith, donor changes.
All right, so as we mentioned before, we're focusing on the donor experience. It'll be simpler, more fun. People will be able to donate in ways that they are comfortable with. We will, in the past, we've really tried to focus more on it being an online event, but now we're going to focus on it being a donation event. So more opportunities for people to give in person, mail it in, call it in, you know, maybe have a phone bank, you know, something like that, but just multi-channel ways for people to donate, not just online. An opportunity for donors to donate early, as we had mentioned, and to set up a recurring donation. So I love that, you know. So somebody might give $10 right there, they can make it recurring. So that's something that you can promote. There's some more peer-to-peer fundraising opportunities. So, you know, maybe your board members, if they want to set up a campaign and do some peer-to-peer fundraising, that is available to you. We do want to have, I think, fewer, but just more attractive, I guess. Just donor lounges that have more happening. You know, like in the Florence building, you know, we did have some pizza, but it wasn't very well advertised. But, you know, massages and pizza and music and, you know, just like make it really attractive for people to come to the donor lounges that we have. We've already secured the credit union as our top sponsor again. We're really excited about that. And, you know, we're talking to them about, you know, maybe they'll have a kickoff party in their parking lot or something like that, where they'll have a pig and there'll be a keg, you know. And so we'll be doing it, it'll be more festive because of the timing, and we can do a really great kickoff party from 6 to midnight, and then we can do a really fun wrap-up party as well. So take advantage of that. And then I was also going to mention puppies and pizza, very creative and fun. A lot of people went up to the fort, and you know, it's not easy to get people to go out there. So some more of that kind of idea. And earlier and more widespread promotion in the community. So GiveGab is going to be doing a lot of things that we won't have to do, like registering you guys. So that will give us the opportunity to spend more of our time on promoting the day and, you know, getting more sponsors and building the funds, the matching your share funds. So that is about that. And with that, we will have our presentation with Bridget from GiveGab. So she'll walk you through, I think, the website, the registration process, and you'll have a chance to ask questions of her. So.
All right, it looks like we're ready to get started. Hi, everyone. My name is Bridget Cafaro, and I am on the customer success team here at GiveGab, the tech platform behind Missoula Gives 2017. We are so excited to be a partner behind this day, and I just wanted to just show off a little bit about the process of how nonprofits get started. The Missoula Gives website is just not ready yet. We're putting the finishing touches on that for you, so you'll be able to register through that site sometime in January, but I wanted to show you what that process is like by presenting a giving day that will look pretty similar to what you'll see on the Missoula Gives site. So here we have Illinois Gives, which is a day of giving we just had. This day, there's custom branding that would be specifically designed for Missoula Gives. That's all around to be your day, so it won't look like this, but it would be very similar to the process, the sign up, the registration, all of that great stuff, all of those features will be all the same. So I just want to walk you through this process a little bit, and if you have any questions, we'll get to those a little bit after we go through this process. So I'm going to jump right in. So once you get to the Missoula Give site, once that registration period is open, you will see this big register now button, a big call to action on that main page, where you'll be able to register your nonprofit to sign up and participate in the day. So when you click that button on the page, you'll be asked to search for your nonprofit. Now, if your nonprofit has already used GiveGab in the past, you may see yourself there, but I have a feeling most of you probably haven't used GiveGab before, which means you'll just need to add your organization. And to do that, you're going to want to click this button right down here, and that will automatically take you to a registration form where you'll need to fill out some basic information about your organization to set up your profile on GiveGab for Missoula Gives. So you can see it's just your organization name, your mailing address, as well as some login information so that you're able to access your Missoula Gives profile. Now, if you're the one setting up your profile, you know, multiple people are going to need to access this, and you don't know, you know, which email to use, who should have, you know, main control, don't have to worry about that right now. You'll be able to add multiple people, give them access to your Missoula Gives profile once you get set up. So whoever is setting this up, don't worry about that. Just fill this information with your own personal login information so you're able to access that page whenever we need to. So once that's all filled out, you're going to click finish, and that's where you get to GiveGab on your Missoula Gives dashboard. So we want to make it as easy as possible for everyone to go through all of the steps they need to complete to be successful on a day of giving. So we have this really great preparation checklist that walks you through each step that we think is the most important to customize your profile, tell your organization story, really share that impact that you hope your donors will have when they give to your organization on Missoula Gives. So we really want to make it as easy as possible by providing these tools and resources for you. So you can see here, there's all these different tabs that I'll expand upon in a little bit, that you can just go through, and once you're done with each of those, they'll actually turn to a green check mark, so you can know exactly when you've done everything you need to do to be successful and be prepared for Missoula Gives. We also have some helpful links that will automatically direct you to resources on the Missoula Gives site, as well as other things you can do, like what link to share for your page, how to share it on Twitter and Facebook, and other great resources that I'll jump into in a little bit. But this is generally where you're going to do most of the work on your Missoula Gives campaign page. So first, we just ask you to add some basic information about your organization. Again, you know, a quick tagline if you have one about your Missoula Gives campaign, your organization's website, which does come into play with our redundancy and security backup plans, which I'll get into a little bit later, as well as your organization's logo, and three different causes that you think best represent what your organization serves. And these causes actually come into play on the day of giving. We have this really easy multi-give feature so that if someone is giving to one organization on the day, they'll be able to, after they've made that gift, on that confirmation page, they'll be suggested to take a look at some other organizations that match up with that cause they've already donated to, so they can find other organizations that might be of interest to them. So definitely pick a couple causes that best represent what you do and your mission, so that during that process, donors can really look around and see new organizations that they might be more interested in, or how to be a part of other organizations. So once you do that, you're going to click save, and then head to the Add Your Story tab. This is probably the most important part of your Missoula Gives campaign, because this is really where you're going a step beyond what your mission does. You're really telling a story about the people that you serve, how you give back to Missoula, and how Missoula can be a part of the work that you do. You can add a custom cover photo. We have this really great editor that you can customize all of your formatting, from different text styles to bold, underline. You can have photos, links, tables. We even have an HTML editor if you have someone super tech savvy, to make it really customizable and branded to what your Missoula Gives mission is. We want to make sure that you're able to do as much customization as possible so you can really tell an authentic and unique story that your organization wants to tell. You can also set a specific goal for the day, though that is optional. And if you have a great video of, you know, something in your organization or something that's promoting Missoula Gives, you can absolutely add that to your page by adding a link right here. The next step of completing your profile is to add your bank account information. So with GiveGab and Missoula Gives this year, we will direct deposit all the donations you receive right into a bank account that you set up within 24 to 48 hours of you receiving those donations. So it's a really quick, easy process. process so you don't have to wait around for a check, and that money gets to you as quickly as possible, because we know it's super important for you to have those funds and to be able to account for all of the gifts you receive. So this is the quick process for you to set up that form so that we can also verify your nonprofit. We do check your EIN with GuideStar and the IRS database and tax-deductible organizations to show that all organizations participating are eligible to receive tax-deductible donations, to provide a level of trust in all of the donors that will be visiting Missoula Gives to know that these are trusted nonprofits that they can give to. So that's really important for us and for all of the days of giving that we do. So once that's set up, you'll be able to accept donations on the platform. It may take up to 2 to 3 business days for your organization to be completely verified, but we do get that going super quick, and we work with you to make sure that that's all set up so that you're ready to go for the day. The next section on this checklist is adding donation levels. So donation levels are kind of building on that story that you're telling by highlighting the impact a donor can specifically have on your organization and what you do. So you can add specific amounts, specific descriptions, and even photos for those amounts so that people can really get a visual image of the tangible impact that they'll have by making a donation to your cause. So again, we really want to provide that level of customization for you so that you can better tell your story to your supporters and provide that level of impact for them. On this section, you can also opt in to collect phone numbers and addresses from your donors. GiveGap doesn't automatically choose to collect this information from your donors. We only ask for their email address and credit card information to complete a transaction, because we find that when you ask for phone numbers and mailing addresses, it can really slow down the donation process and prevent someone from making that final donation. But we do know that many organizations do need that information for vital, you know, direct mailing and phone accounts and things like that. So if you do that information, make sure to check this box so that you're able to have all of that great data that you need going forward. The next step is to add a custom thank you message. So on GiveGap, we will actually automatically send anyone that makes a donation to your organization through Missoula Gives a confirmation email that has a personalized thank you message. And it doesn't come from GiveGap, it doesn't come from Missoula Gives. It comes from whoever your organization sets as the contact person for your nonprofit. So it's really customizable. You can have a personal message, a video, a thank you image, so that it really feels like it's coming from somebody in your organization, and that it's very personal, not just a generic receipt. Although that thank you message also includes a receipt for that person's donation, so it will have your organization's EIN number, it will have the donation amount, because we know on a day of giving, it can get really hectic and you've got a lot going on, so it does take away a sense of immediacy for you, knowing that your donors are immediately being thanked and provided with that little element of delight, knowing that they gave back to a worthy cause. And then the last step on that checklist that you see is to add fundraisers. So GiveGap, we have some really great peer-to-peer fundraising tools, kind of, you know, building around that crowdfunding idea where you can recruit your supporters, whether it's your board members, your volunteers, some of your donors, your staff members, people that are really passionate about what you do, that you know have a big voice and are ready to share their support in ways, and fundraising on your behalf. So you can recruit fundraisers, as well as have a fundraise button on your profile so that anyone who maybe stumbles on it or, you know, just wants to join in the movement will be able to rally around their cause on their own by creating their own personal fundraising page that will actually be a bit of a spin-off of your own Missoula Gives campaign. So that's kind of the checklist that we go through to make sure that your profile is complete, that you have everything you need to make a beautiful story, to tell that to your supporters, so that when they do stumble on your profile, there's really something there that's special. It feels like something that your organization was there. You know, it's not too generic, it's not bland. You can really do a lot of customization to make it feel like your organization's story. That's really important to us. So on that same preparation checklist, we know your Missoula Gives dashboard, as we call it, you'll see some other helpful links that will direct you to other resources we have. So this checklist helps you be successful on your profile, making sure that's complete. But all of these other steps kind of involve the whole day of giving process. So we have links to the webinars and workshops you'll be attending before, so you can make sure to sign up for those, watch any recordings for any of those webinars or workshops that you may have missed, so that you are as prepared as possible for the day. We also have a link to the Giving Day Toolkit, which has a ton of great resources. I'll show off in a little bit, like email templates, ways to get your board involved, downloadable graphics for your promotional materials, things like that to make everything leading up to the day as easy as possible for you to have the most amount of success on the Zoom gifts. And then if you have any questions about GiveDab or the process or how to do things technically, we have a great customer success headquarters that you can navigate to that will answer any of your questions. But if you don't find the answer to your question there, you may see this little blue chat bubble in the bottom right-hand corner of your screen. Now that chat bubble is a direct link to GiveDab's customer success team. And we're here to answer any questions you have, whether it's technical or about the day of giving or just about fundraising in general. We love to hear from you, and we typically respond in under 5 minutes during business days. So we can see exactly what page you're on the site and help you navigate what you're doing so that we can help you complete that profile and feel really confident in the page that you'll be sharing from Missoula Gives, because they want you to really love what you're sharing. So please feel free to use that chat bubble if you're ever on GiveGab or Missoula Gives to ask any questions to our team. We'll be very happy to help. Additionally, there's other things you can do, like add additional administrators. If there are multiple people at your organization who do need access to that page, you can absolutely do that, as well as add offline gifts. So if you're collecting donations outside of the platform, whether it's from your own website, cash, or check, we want to hear from you. We want to know that those numbers are being counted toward Missoula Gifts, so it's really easy to add those offline donations to your organization's totals so that all of those amounts are reflected in the whole Missoula Gifts movement. We also have a really great matching feature, so that if you do have a matching sponsor, you can highlight that on your profile, and it will automatically attribute that match amount to your total, so your donors can really see that impact in real time. And you can also manage all of your donations, edit your donations. There's a lot you can do, and we'll of course be going over this all again in a lot more detail as we get closer to Missoula Gives and answer all of your questions after the fact. So here's an example of that nonprofit Giving Day toolkit that we have. So you can see there's some great tools here, like building board support. There's a planning guide, communications timeline that kind of breaks it down into, you know, from small nonprofits to large nonprofits to nonprofits that have 4 weeks to get ready to nonprofits that have 6 months to get ready. We have all different types of tools for all different types of nonprofits to make it as easy as possible for everyone to be successful, regardless of your size and how much time you have to commit to preparing for Missoula Gives. We also have some promotional materials and social media guides and templates. So all you really have to do is copy, paste, and personalize. And that message is ready to go for you to send out to your supporters. Again, making it as easy as possible for you to get the word out about Missoula Gives and get your supporters excited to support you. And then lastly is that downloadable goodies section where we have a ton of great graphics like social share images, the Missoula Gives logo, and things that you can add to your own promotional materials to promote your participation, and things like that to get people excited, to make sure that they know you're participating, and to get the word out about Missoula Gives by using those images and graphics. So on Missoula Gives, people will be able to search for an organization a couple different ways. There'll be a big give back button right on the homepage of Missoula Gives website that people will click. And then they'll be able to search for your organization in a couple of ways. So they can search by name, so just by typing your organization's name or a keyword at your organization, and that will pull in both your organization's name on the site as well as any information that's in that story section as to capture all the information so that anyone can find what they're looking for. They can also search by a specific location or by those causes that you select. So if someone's really interested in helping animals, they can just look at organizations that support animals or seniors or arts and culture or things like that, so people can really find the causes that they're looking for. And once they do find your organization's profile, they'll be able to view it, donate, share, fundraise, all of these great things. So you can see here are some of the elements I added before. That cover photo right up at the top. My logo over here. Here's that goal bar so people can see exactly how much I raised towards my goal on the day, how many donors have supported my cause, as well as those donation levels, your story, Your fundraising champions, your recent donors, all of that will be over here. So again, it really does feel like you're telling your organization's story, but it is tied in with that entire Missoula Gives branding, so that under your trusted organization participating in this day, and that it's an important thing to give back to. So part of the donation flow, I just want to show off a little bit. So when someone gives to your organization, they do have this really great donation form that is completely branded to Missoula Gives. To this is an example of a donation form that doesn't require mailing address or phone number. You can see it just requires the donation amount and credit card information as well as an email address. So you will have all of your donors' email addresses if you do not opt in to collect phone numbers and addresses. So you'll still be able to get in touch with those supporters for more information or to reach out in the future. They also have the option to leave a message, to make a gift in memories of someone or in support of someone, or make their gift anonymous. So you can see on this confirmation page, we give donors the option to cover the fees on behalf of your organization. And we do not check that box automatically. Donors have to opt in to cover those fees on your behalf. And on the platform, we find about 70 to 75% of donors typically opt in to cover the fees on your behalf. And just to clarify, those fees for Missoula Gives will be a 2% platform fee for GiveGap, as well as a 2.2% plus 30 cent credit card processing fee for all major credit cards, and then it's a 3.5% plus 30 cent credit card processing fee for American Express credit cards, which we typically find are less than 10% of all donations made on the platform. So most of your donations will be through that card, but we'll of course leave all that information for you. And we'll be going over that again if you have any questions about the pricing and all of that great things. But in addition to that pricing, you'll also have access to GiveGap's engaged suite of donor management features free of charge for the month after Missoula Gives, because we just want you to be able to manage those donors, really utilize some of those tools we have for you on GiveGap to make sure that you're stewarding these relationships as best as you can after Missoula Gives. So you can opt in to cover those fees for donors, as well as make it a monthly gift right on the platform so that people can choose to support you regularly throughout the year. And then once you submit that donation, you'll get this really great confirmation message showing that your donation went through, thanking you for supporting an organization, as well as again, tying in those other causes. So it brings in causes that are similar or the same to the one you just supported. So you can take a look around and see if there's something else you may be interested in supporting. So again, bringing together all of the nonprofits in Missoula and all the people of Missoula to support as many organizations as they want to, as they are proud to support, because we really want to provide that for people being a part of all the great things that Missoula has to offer. And then once they see this message, they'll also receive that custom confirmation email that comes from your contact person. So they're thanked not once but twice right on the platform. And then they'll be able to go back to your profile, a few other organizations. And we actually do save their credit card information for about 15 to 20 minutes or until they close out of their browser for security reasons. So if there is a donor that wants to give to multiple organizations, it is very easy to do so. So they can just continue to make gifts as they please. So that's most of my presentation, just about the setup and the resources that will be provided. And I'd be happy to answer any questions that anyone has about the platform, about Missoula Gives, about GiveGab. Please, Nikki, feel free to send those by me so I can answer them for people. So Nikki asked about our failover plan. So, you've heard a lot of giving news sites, crushing and not being very transparent with organizations, and we absolutely can't stand that. It's very important to us that we have a site that is reliable and transparent for everyone that's participating. So GiveGap has what's called a redundancy plan. And a redundancy plan basically means, So it's basically saying that, if any element of the Giving Day site fails, we have a backup in place that will automatically replace it. And because we are hosted on the cloud, it makes it very easy for that to happen. So at no point will the site ever going to be down because we have all of these backup servers and plans in place, but if one component fails, there's already a backup ready to support what has caused that to go down. Additionally, we also load test all of our sites incredibly before the day to make sure that they're ready to handle the extreme amount of donors that will be visiting the site on the day, because again, we really want it to be as easy as possible for people. We don't want it to be slow or anything like that. We want people to be able to give quickly and easily without having to wait for a loading screen or something like that. So we really want to make sure that it's as smooth as possible for your donors. And again, if there are any issues on the day, we believe in complete transparency with all of our nonprofits. So we already have plans in place. If anything would happen to go, if something were to go wrong, we would be in communication with you immediately, and all of those plans would immediately be put into place. So essentially, nothing can go wrong on Missoula Gives. That's what we want you to do. We want you to know that you don't have to worry about those things, because we have taken care of it for you, because we really want you to feel confident and excited, not have to worry about technical problems like that. So we've gotten covered. Someone asked if they already have a Stripe account, if they can use their Stripe account. Unfortunately, when you do sign up for GiveGab and have that main account, you're not creating a new Stripe account. You're creating a managed account with GiveGab. So it's a little bit different than the Stripe account you may have to process donations for the phone website. But for this specific circumstance, it's a managed account that GiveGab handles for you. It deals with all those transfers. We deal with Stripe so that you don't have to. So unfortunately, you wouldn't be able to use your own personal Stripe account.
Anybody else have any last minute questions? Erin?
Is there a way to, for the donor to cover the transaction fees?
Yes. Yes. And I think she said about 70% of their donors seem to. It's okay. Anybody else?
To have the location search field. If it's only going to be in Missoula.
Yeah, I love that too. I'm pretty sure we can design it the way we want it to, because I thought about that too. So the Lolo.
Yeah.
On follow-up events,
if it's necessary to have a location search field. If it's just for Missoula Gives, we may not have that feature. We'll talk to the Missoula Gives team about what they want. So that might not necessarily be there on the day.
No. Anybody else?
Well, you mentioned the possibility of using this platform for future events.
Yep.
Are those at a cost, or are they just because you've already got the platform set up and things? Meaning, or would you have to pay for that as an additional use of GiveGab, or?
No, I mean, but the fee is different, so, and I know we are running up against our next event at 10, but we've just got a couple minutes left.
Nonprofits want to know how to find out the cost of using the platform at other times of the year. So if you head to givegab.com, we have a page that details all of our pricing plans. However, it is completely free to sign up for GiveGab. There are no subscription costs, no monthly costs on our most basic plan. The only cost to use GiveGab is if you choose to use us for fundraising, in which we charge a platform fee and those credit card processing fees, which your donors always have the option to cover year-round, not just and I'd be happy to send that link directly along to me to share with you, or if you just head to www.givegab.com, you should be able to find that link quite easily right on the site.
All right, any last minute questions? Final question.
I have one more question. If donors choose to continue monthly, does that go through their website every time, or
yes,
we move it over to our website?
It's the GiveGab website. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay, I think that's about it. Anyone? Okay.
Thanks, everybody.